To gain the most amount of points as possible, you want to maximize your consistency. In this video, you are going to learn everything you need to know about gaining points in arena fast. If you watch the entire video, by the end, you'll be gaining a ton more arena points than you are now. Let's go. For the first tip in this video, we're going to be talking about the first thing in your games, and that's your drop spot. So many people struggle to gain arena points simply because they die off spawn far too often, and they barely maintain their points just relying on pop-off games to gain back all their bus fare. However, this tip is extremely helpful for dying off spawn, and that's just to plan out your drop spot. Having a drop spot or a few drop spots around the map that you have mastered and have planned out a drop map and loot path for each can make such a difference to your games. Having a drop spot that you know well and can consistently outdrop everyone for and loot the most efficiently can give you so much of an advantage over all of your opponents, and sometimes you can not only get an advantage in those off-spawn fights, but you can get completely free kills either because you outdrop someone for a weapon or chest, or you just loot so well that you get full shield and a shotgun and mats and they don't. I recommend using the website Fortnite.gg and the in-game battle lab mode to find two different drop spots at least. These drop spots could really be anywhere, but they need to have at least 6 chests per player, so just 6 chests if you're playing solos, areas to get every material or at least somewhere to rotate to in order to find those materials, and preferably some rotation like a car, boat, or built-in launch pad. A few decent outskirt drop spots are any of the new henchman bases around the map with the new cars and launch pads, Flopper Island up the north, and the southeast sort of valley, which is actually where FNCS All-Star winner on NA East Pamstu lands. You should also be looking for a loot route through these spots that allows you to hit as many chests and get as many materials as fast as you can. After you've found your drop spot using Fortnite.gg and Battle Lab, you should go into Battle Lab and Fortnite.gg and try to find out the most efficient loot path for that drop spot. Once you've found that most efficient loot path, make sure you record it into Fortnite.gg and save it so you can always come back to it. After you found your drop spots, probably an outskirt spot or two and a POI that doesn't have the entire lobby landing at it, and mapped out the perfect loot route for them, you should use the website landingtutorial.com, link in the description of course, to make a drop map that you can save on Fortnite.gg. How this site works is that you basically put in the bus path and the spot where you want to land, and it automatically finds where you should drop out of the battle bus and where you should deploy your glider for the perfect drop. You should use this for every drop spot, rotating the bus path around the map and recording it onto your map on Fortnite.gg. After you've done this, you'll basically have a circle of where you should drop for any bus path, so now you can always get the perfect drop. This will give you a massive advantage in the early game, and you'll gain way more arena points because of it. Now, moving on to the next part of the game, the mid game. Understanding what the dead side of zone is and how to use it to your advantage to gain more arena points. The goal of your gameplay, if you want to gain as many arena points as possible, is to play very consistently. Instead of what we talked about before, where you die off spawn and have to rely on pop-off games to gain points, you should be playing consistently, gaining back your bus fare at least every game, and then gaining some more points through a few eliminations or high placement. And the dead side of zone will help you do exactly this. So, the dead side of zone, if you're not familiar with it already, is just the side of zone with the least amount of players on it. This side of zone exists simply because when zones don't directly pull in the center, there will be a side of zone that less players have to rotate to because there are less POIs that players need to rotate from to that same spot. It might sound complex now, but once you get it, you'll get it, and you'll be able to rotate there every game and abuse it to gain more arena points. Speaking of using the dead side to your advantage, now that we know what it is and how to get there, let's talk about how you can use it to your advantage. Since the dead side of zone is the side of zone with the least players on it, you can go there and just play placement to avoid everyone. However, that's not really what you should be doing. The real thing that's special about dead side in arena is that it allows you to take very safe fights. Fighting on dead side means that you'll never get third partied because you can easily fight safely. This means that you'll be able to consistently gain more points from eliminations because you'll be able to get them safely and more consistently. You can play your fights on dead side just like fights in creative without getting being punished much for having bad awareness. Apart from fighting, deadside can also be used to get more wins, because if you're in a side of zone with less players, then all of your rotates to further zones on in the game will be much easier. That means you'll be able to consistently make it to endgame with max mats and without using any heals. Overall, that's how you use deadside to gain more arena points, and now let's get on to the next topic. So, next up for this video, let's talk about what game mode you should play to gain the maximum amount of arena points. As you guys all probably know, this season we've had some big format changes in arena that make trios and duos much better for gaining arena points. But are they better than solos? Well, it depends. But because of what I'm going to talk about in the last tip in this video that you're going to want to stick around for, I still recommend playing solos as your main arena game mode. Not only is solos very good for gaining arena points, it's the best game mode to improve as a player, something that's even more valuable than just gaining points. Of course, if you get bored of solos or you just have some mates on that you want to play with, you can still play duo or trio arena, as they are really good now for gaining points if you can find some decent players to play with. Playstyle. How should you be playing in arena? Should you W key or should you play placement? Well, it depends. If you're in a lower division, then you should definitely be W keying everyone you see, especially if you're in open league, because there's literally zero bus fare, so you won't lose anything if you die. However, once you get into a division that does have bus fare and that you find yourself unable to fully W key in, that's when you should start thinking about what playstyle you should adopt to gain the most points. And as I mentioned in the previous tips in this video, to gain the most amount of points as possible, you want to maximize your consistency. This means that you should neither play placement or full W key, and that you should only play this smart playstyle instead. This means that after your offspawn game, you should aim to rotate to dead side, farm up, and play for endgame, taking only smart fights. You shouldn't be afraid to take these smart fights like you're playing full placement, but you shouldn't full W key anyone if you don't need to either. You shouldn't be full W keying everyone, because then you'll end up far too inconsistent in your games, but you also shouldn't be playing full placement, because while that does have the potential to be extremely consistent, you just aren't making enough of the opportunities to get extra elimination points, so you just won't rank up as fast. If you aren't confident in even playing the smart fighting playstyle and dealing with the amount of fights that comes with it, then you should be really working on your fights first. But if you are comfortable taking a few fights when you need to and when you think it's a good opportunity, then this is the playstyle that you should be adopting. With this playstyle, you'll always be able to make endgame in a position good enough to win the game with all the resources that you need, and that will get you so many more arena points overall. And the next topic of today's video is going to be, to gain arena points as fast as possible, you should actually stop focusing on gaining points completely. This is because focusing on gaining arena points is actually bad for your improvement. It leads you down a negative path of being too caught up in point gain that you never focus on improvement and are always trying to exploit little tricks that don't involve any skill or learning, like landing in the ocean and AFKing and getting you back your bus fare and at least one placement point in order to gain points. What you should be really focusing on, though, is improvement. And I hate to say it, but improvement is going to result in losing arena points. You're going to have to full W key games to improve fighting and die a lot because of it. And you're going to have to sacrifice time that you had to play arena to aim train or play scrims. That's just how it is. And if you want to gain points and improve in the long run, then you need to just drop the ego and lose some points in order to improve. But then after a while, you'll easily gain those points back and much more because of how much better you'll be at the game. It's like an investment, and it works amazingly if you're really looking to level up your gameplay. One player who's done this amazingly and has had a lot of success as a result of those methods that I just talked about is the GOAT himself, probably the best player in the game, Taysen. I recently made a video on him, so go check it out to learn some stuff.